بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه من والاه. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. And welcome to this week's episode of Friday Nasiha from ProductiveMuslim.com. Today's episode is Productivity to the End. If we talk about the productivity life cycle, I mean, what I mean by the life cycle, you have an idea and you normally get really excited about the idea. And those first few days, first few hours, you're really productive with that idea. And then you hit a challenge or two, and your productivity slows down. And then you hit more challenges, and your productivity really slows down. By the end of the project, or even halfway through the project, some of you might have dropped the idea completely, or added it to your procrastination list. And this is a very, very typical productivity life cycle with any project, any idea, anything we decide to work on. So today I'm going to talk about how to be productive to the end and the importance of being productive to the end. I want us all to reflect on this hadith of Muhammad sallam. He said, verily actions are by their endings. The testimony of your productivity, the testimony of how well you've done something, is not how you begun, it's how you finished it. It's the last sprint. How did you really come to the, how did you run that last mile? If you notice the marathon, it's not the first 10 laps or 6 laps or 4 laps that matter. It's that last mile. That's when the excitement is. That's when everyone is looking who will be the winner. And that what really, really counts. You can have the most amazing marathon, but if you don't finish properly, you'll be the last one. You'll be the loser. So actions are by their endings. And this is a call for you to really take your productivity to the end. I know you'll come to hurdles. I know you'll become difficult. I know you think, what's the point? I just want to sit down and not, you know, I just this idea was a bad idea from the beginning. Don't leave something hanging. Don't leave an idea hanging. Either you completely axe it and learn the lessons from it, or you finish it to the end. So let's talk about this last sprint. How can you make sure that you get that you run your last sprint? First of all, don't quit. And you know, there's many ways you can do this. Number one is to tell yourself, I am not going to quit. And really encourage yourself and push yourself not to quit. Secondly, remember the reward, especially if it's a project, if it's a sadaqah project, if it's a charity project, if it's something that's going to help somebody, remember the reward attached to it. Say, you know, I'm doing this for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I'm doing this to, you know, to help my ummah. I'm doing this to help the Muslims. So remember the reward, and it will encourage you to run to the end. Thirdly, remember why you started. Remember those first exciting hours, those first exciting days. Remember why you started in the first place. What made you, pushed you to say, yes, I want to do this. What made you productive those first few hours? Remember, sometimes when you remember why you started something, that's what really pushes you. Sometimes I even get with ProductiveMuslim.com, with the website itself, when I remember those first few hours when I started this blog, that those first few hours were so exciting, and those first few hours were really push me sometimes to remember to continue and to plow through and to really help develop good content, inshallah. Get support and help. Talk to your family, talk to your friends. Say that, you know what, I'm just, you know, if you're really frustrated, say to them, I'm just frustrated. This is getting tiring. You know, I don't know if I can do this. I don't know if it's a good idea. And get the support. Sometimes they can reframe things for you. Sometimes they can say something to you, one word or two words, and that can really, you know, encourage you and freshen you up to run the last sprint. And finally, freshen up. What I mean by this is sometimes take a break. You know, if you've been running and focusing and being productive with this one thing for such a long time, you might just need a break. You might not want to completely axe this project. You might just need to take a break for one day, 2 days, a week maybe, and then come back. There's an article on ProductiveMuslim.com called Time Out. If you search on ProductiveMuslim.com, come across this time out. It talks about how you can take time out from your general everyday rhythm, and so you can freshen up and come back to your productivity full scale. So I hope you enjoyed this week's final siha, and inshallah speak to you next week. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.